Manafort gave that same intermediary internal polling data from the Trump campaign during the campaign. Shortly after meeting in person with Manafort's intermediary, Oleg Deripaska ends up on a yacht with a nice young escort who has a very active Instagram account, and the deputy prime minister of Russia.
Manafort has been on Deripaska's payroll since 2005. And since then, he is said to be lobbying for the Kremlin and Putin in Washington. Deripaska paid for this. Here's the person making the decisions on the yacht and discussing the issues on the video with Deripaska. Nastya Rybka, an eyewitness, tells us all about it.
I don't think Manafort's going to cooperate. I think he's more scared of the Russians than he is of jail here in the United States.
When you say that, what do you mean?
Well, I mean, I think we know now from the exhibit list that he had a significant loan from Oleg Deripaska. He was in debt to him, and I think he's scared that if he cooperated and provided information about Russian attacks on our election and possible conspiracy with the Trump campaign, that the Russians would come after him.
She was arrested in February 2018, days after the Navalny expose went public. She told the Times, quote, they were discussing elections. Deripaska had a plan about elections.
She says that she witnessed meetings between the Russian billionaire Oleg Deripaska and at least three Americans who she refused to name. She claims they discussed plans to affect the U.S. elections.
The Russian government freaked out so badly about this expose that Navalny was running that Deripaska and the Russian government got a court in Russia to block Alexei Navalny's website. All she wanted to say in court was how sorry she is to Oleg Deripaska and how she does not want to upset him anymore and how she cannot take much more of this.